Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Well, welcome to worship. It's the sixth Sunday in the season of Easter. And today in scripture and in worship, we hear again the promises and the words of Jesus that he will not abandon us, that he gives us the gift of the promise of the Holy Spirit. And he calls us to be able to abide with him and calls us forward to be able to follow his commandments of love and care. And so we cling to those words of promise today as we worship and give thanks and praise to God. One announcement, even though we can't gather in person together today, which would normally be a Sunday that we celebrate Music Sunday here at Gloria Day, we invite you to watch for a post to be put on our website and YouTube page, a post in which we will be able to watch and be a part of last year's Music Sunday worship and songs and anthems, and we'll be able to enjoy those. Even though we can't gather together today in person for worship, to be able to celebrate, we still recognize the wonderful gifts that God gives us. The gift of community, the gift of this congregation, the gift of Jesus' presence and the promise of the Holy Spirit, and of course the gift of music, in which we give thanks and praise to God today. Welcome to worship. We begin worship with a thanksgiving for baptism. So you're welcome to grab a bowl at home, fill it with water. And you're welcome to also make the sign of the cross on your forehead, both before worship and while we celebrate the thanksgiving for baptism. We begin. We remember our baptism in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are raised with him into new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image, and you planted us in a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched, and you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you watered us from Jesus' wounded side. And on this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for your gift of your salvation through water, for the water of this font, and for water everywhere. Bathe us in your forgiveness, in your grace, and in your love. Satisfy the thirsty and give us the life that only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ and the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Prayer of the day. Let us pray together. Almighty and ever-living God, you hold together all things in heaven and on earth. In your great mercy, receive the prayers of all your children and give to all the world the spirit of your truth and peace. Through Jesus our Lord. Amen. A reading from Psalm 66. Bless our God, you peoples. Let the sound of praise be heard. Come and listen, all of you who believe, and I will tell you what God has done for me. I called out to God with my mouth and praised the Lord with my tongue. If I had cherished evil in my heart, the Lord would not have heard me. But in truth, God has heard me and has attended to the sound of my prayer. Blessed be God who has not rejected my prayer nor withheld unfailing love from me. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 14th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me. And you in me, and I in you, they who have my commandments and keeping them are those loose who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Pastors aren't the only ones who like to share stories. One day a pastor was bringing her car in for an oil change. It was a slow Friday morning, and Al, the owner of the shop, he was eager for conversation. He shared one story that was particularly powerful. Al grew up in a small town. His parents' best friends had a six-year-old son who was being bullied. Every day he was walking to school, as he was walking to school, a group of older boys would ambush him and steal his lunch money. Desperate to keep him safe, that six-year-old parents had talked to their best friends, and they had volunteered their son, Al, who was 12 years old, a few years older, and a whole lot bigger than their son. And they had volunteered him into walking this six-year-old boy to school. So it was all set in motion. Al was this little boy's protector. It turns out when this little boy grew up, he was running for a major political office in this country. Al went to one of his campaign rallies a few years ago, and he managed to get close enough to be able to speak to him, calling him by his childhood nickname. And immediately the candidate pulled Al close and said, "Don't call me by that name," and then reminded Al of what his given name, his formal name, is. What seems interesting about the story is not so much that a little boy needed protection on his way to school. I mean, we all have times and places when this is so. What seemed so interesting was this strong desire to leave any reminder of that hard time behind him. No doubt Al's very appearance at this campaign rally brought to mind an unwelcome memory of a time in which this six-year-old boy, who is now a man, felt vulnerable. And ironically, at a moment in time when in his life when he felt like he could show no weakness. I expect he felt his entire future depended on it, and you know, maybe it did. I can't say as I blame him, really. I mean, I know that I too cringe to remember the names and the faces of the children who made my life miserable in kindergarten. So as I hear Jesus' promise for us today, I expect it goes without saying that none of us wants to be orphaned. None of us likes to be vulnerable in need of protection, or in particular, as was the case with the disciples to whom Jesus first spoke these words, for them to feel without the presence of their beloved master and leader, their guide and their friend. In fact, Jesus knew this even before the disciples did, as he speaks to them in today's very gospel reading. Yes, he knew that they and that we would need more than just the memory of who he is to be able to carry us forward. He knew that we too would need an advocate, a protector, a teacher, a guide in this Holy Spirit promised to us now. Otherwise, we might well find ourselves in much the same situation, like a little boy walking alone to school, vulnerable to the bullies of this world, and unable to grow into all that we were created to be. Now, the young boy, of course, was not orphaned, even though he may have felt like he was. He had parents who were looking out for him and who, in this instance, called in the help of longtime friends to be able to change the course of his first grade year. I don't think it's too much of a stretch for us to say that Al, who grew up to own his own auto repair shop, may have looked a lot like the promised Holy Spirit now. Just by walking alongside of him, Al stood between a little boy and bullies who would take his lunch money, making sure that he got safely to school. And at the same time, Al, as a 12-year-old in a small town, was in a very real way keeping the commandments that Jesus speaks of right now. At the direction of his parents, he was loving another as he would have wanted to be loved when he was also 6 years old. And he became a reflection, a living example of what God would have us all be and do. And somehow Jesus is present in that. The Holy Spirit is present in that. It's really hard for us to admit our need for this. I mean, we don't want to be reminded that perhaps we are all still very much like a six-year-old in need of someone to be able to walk us to school. And yet, as I allow myself to recognize this truth in me, I'm able to, without judgment and with a deeper sense of sensitivity and with empathy, to see that need in others too. I sense Jesus' promise kept to me. And so often, I recognize this remarkable gift of God's Spirit in the active presence of others who are living in kindness and compassion for me and shared with me. Do you hear this promise from Jesus? Can you recognize this remarkable gift? In this truth, may we then be reminded that we are called to be and to do the same. Aha, like a certain 12-year-old walking a 6-year-old to school, perhaps the promised Holy Spirit might just show up in and through you too. Amen.
Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Abiding God, you have revealed yourself to us in the form of your Son, Jesus Christ, emboldened your church as your followers to reveal your love to everyone in our speaking and in our living. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You call all people of the world your children. Judge the nations justly, show mercy to the oppressed, and speak truth to power through your prophets. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You come near to us when we are lost, and you hear our distress. We pray for those who suffer in any way. Be with the world in the midst of COVID-19. Bring your healing love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your commands are good and merciful. Give us courage to take hold of our baptismal promises to work for justice, advocate for the voiceless, and free the oppressed and imprisoned in body, mind, or spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You remain with us always, O God, and your kingdom has no end. We remember the saints who have gone before us. Unite us forever in your final victory over death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Strong when I'm on your shoulder.
Merciful God, your ordinary gifts seem small for such a celebration, but you make of them in abundance, just as you do with our lives. We thank you for giving us all we have. Help us use these gifts for service in your name, in the strength of the risen Christ. Amen. We pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May God fill you with joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia! Christ is risen!
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia!
Go in peace. Share the good news.
Thanks be to God.